Let me tell you my personal story. I smoked cigarettes for more than 15 years. Smoking is another type of oral addiction because it's also related to our mouth. That was my method of managing stress and anxiety in my life. I tried to quit many times. A few times I was able to stay without cigarettes for 2-3 months, and then I was drawn back to them. My dad, my brother, most of my friends were smokers. It was the easiest way for me to manage stress and to hide my emotions. When I finally quit smoking, I gained 14 pounds within less than 6 months. I was going to the gym 3-4 times a week and tried to eat healthy. I tried different diets, I tried different exercises, but I always ate more than I needed, especially before bedtime. I replaced one oral addiction, smoking, with another oral addiction, the overeating. That was the only way for me to quit smoking. Extra weight was never a problem for me before. I did not believe that people cannot manage their weight. But once I stopped smoking, I realized that diet and exercise alone don't work for me. I had to dig deeper and find the cause of my overeating problem. For 2 years, I've been learning and researching about psychological reasons for overeating. I tried different psychological methods and exercises. I was learning how to identify my emotions, how to deal with them in a healthy way, and how to express my feelings in a healthy way instead of suppressing them with cigarette or with food. Once I stopped smoking, I realized that I was a very anxious person. And for many years, I was using unhealthy defense mechanisms to suppress my feelings and hide my true emotions. Because I smoke a cigarette every hour or so, I did not even notice the level of stress that I had. I had to admit to myself that being in my 30s, with a bachelor degree in psychology, with more than 200 hours of personal therapy and workshops, online trainings, I was not able to manage my emotions in a healthy way. I was avoiding them and suppressing them with cigarettes and later with food. Now I consider myself to be an expert in overeating psychology. Not only I know the theory about overeating psychology, but I have learned from my own personal experience. I struggled for 2 years. I was able to find the reasons, the true reasons for my overeating or oral addiction. I was able to lose most of my excess weight. I still have 4 pounds to reach my goal, to reach my ideal weight, and I'm still working on myself. It's not easy. I want to be honest with you. It's not easy, and it will take time. But I'm so happy. I'm glad that I decided to take the journey and to step on that path of self-discovery. Today, as I have lost the extra weight, the excess weight, I have gained many unexpected benefits along the way. Lots of insights have came to my mind during my journey. I was able to address my psychological issues related to overeating, and I was able to improve the relationships with myself, with my friends, and I was able to improve my romantic relationships as well. Now I can understand myself better. When I want to eat crackers or nuts, or when I want to chew chicken wings or meat from the bone, I know that I'm trying to suppress my anger. When I want to eat salty food, I know that it's time for me to pay attention to my inner critic. If you would like to know more about how to identify your emotions by the type of food you eat, please watch my webinar entitled "Tell Me What You Eat and I Will Tell You What Problems You Have." The link is in the video description. If you like this video so far, please give me a thumbs up and consider subscribing with hitting the notification bell. I release 2-3 videos every week, so by clicking this notification bell, by subscribing, you will not miss any of my future videos.